And I was like, bro, if I had your, I literally told him, bro, if I had your parents, I could have went to an Ivy League school.
You know?
You know what I'm saying?
Totally.
And so I think most people know.
Yeah.
But maybe they don't.
I don't. Most people that I talk to have never actually thought critically about their own privilege in that way.
When I say systemic, I'm not saying that the entire judicial system is racist.
Yeah.
I'm saying, yeah, it needs some reform, but what I'm saying is systemic from a society standpoint, mm-hmm. that these racist things that happened in the 60s, 70s, and 80s, mm-hmm. And the 90s, mm-hmm. super predators, things that the Clintons yeah. were saying, right? These things trickled over multiple generations, mm-hmm. and they're still impacting Black, brown neighborhoods, and even poor white people as well.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. And yeah, that's where I think is semantics. Just to me, systemic. And it all depends on how you define it.
Right.
You know, because
right.
we can define systemic in a lot of different ways. Like, I think on the over comprehensive, like, cultural system, I mean, that is a system. Mm-hmm. But when I'm talking about systemic, I'm talking about specific legislature, like pen on the paper, legal documents, something that you can actually track and objectively quantify. Mm-hmm. I think the beef that I have with the semantics is that people get so caught up in conflating the two, mm-hmm. that they're not actually focusing on the practical steps that we can be taking towards alleviating, yeah. and moving towards reconciliation, yes. moving towards alleviating poverty.
Yes, yes. Or just empowering people to have some degree of financial literacy, and mm-hmm. you know what I'm saying? Like the very cornerstones of what it takes to be a functioning mm-hmm. human. Sometimes we can just you could just debilitate somebody's ability from trying by telling them they're a victim over and over, mm-hmm. and I don't think that's helping.
But I do see, I think, and I think it's really counterproductive, and I think it can be existentially harmful the way that some people navigate that space, mm-hmm. and saying, all right, so here's a macro statistic and there's a disparity, mm-hmm. therefore this is clear evidence this our entire system is set up biased against Black people because our entire country hates Black people.
Okay, maybe our entire system isn't set up against Black people, mm-hmm. but can we say that our system was built for the benefit of white people? White males, specifically? So it's not against, yeah. it's just, but this is who it's really for.
I mean, in at certain times, absolutely. Okay. Absolutely.
So we agree on that.
Yeah, absolutely at times. But I think that you have to, there's a lot of nuance in that, yes. too. Because we can't just be like, all right, so like, we can't pretend that things haven't changed. We can't pretend that our country is still the same country that it was 50, 100, 200 years
Absolutely.
Ago. And I think pretending that it hasn't changed results in some really pervasively bad ideas that cause a lot of disunity.
Yes.
That cause a lot of impractical and counterproductive thinking.
Yes.
Counterproductive action.
Yep.
And some of that can lead to really counterproductive policy, you know, depending yeah. on
I think we agree on that. And I think I'm more into like, hey, like let's all do our part and let's choose to take ownership of the variables that we could take ownership of.
Right.
And yes, certain people start at an advantage. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I think people need to
start at a disadvantage. But regardless, let's take ownership of the hand that we have, mm-hmm. and let's do the very best of the hand that we have. And if and not to legislate, but if I'm doing really well, mm-hmm. because my dad is an entrepreneur and we're immigrants and I have that chip on my shoulder and society views me as a white male, therefore I have some degree of white privilege, my personal choice, not because someone told me, not because something legislated, I'm choosing to help pull up and create as much economic opportunity for people who did not have maybe the same advantages, even though I grew up in a single parent mm-hmm. home and whatever, divorced family. I'm making that concerted effort to help as many people as I can to create.
Absolutely. And I think everybody needs to like have an acute awareness of their own privileges,
Absolutely.
The things that they've earned and the things that they haven't earned.
Yes.
And we simplify it towards like things like white privilege so badly.
Yeah.
You know, and like we box people into these ideas that like you're the sum of your immutable characteristics. Mm-hmm. But let's really break it down. Let's talk about privilege. It's like the greatest privilege that you have is like whether or not you have parents at all, you know, whether or not you're able-bodied. Okay, so now you have parents. Are your parents moral people? Are they responsible people?
Do they
sacrifice time for you?
Do your parents love each other?
Yeah, do they love each other? Right. Do they love you? Not every parent loves their children. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
How smart are your parents? How smart are you?
Yeah.
You know, there's an untold infinite amount of privileges and disadvantages that's unique to every individual. And I think we have to be sober and aware of like what is our earned and what is our unearned privilege.
Yep.
I think that helps with pride. And I think that also just helps like, you know, realize it's like, hey, not everybody had the immutable unearned things that I have. Mm-hmm. And how can I help? You know, how can I help love people knowing that, you know, people are still made in the image of God, that I'm still called to love and they still have value.
Yeah.
You know?
I met Paul Russell's parents in Dallas. What day was that? Yesterday. And, they were amazing. They're in their 50s. And Paul Russell, if you guys don't know who Paul Russell is, check out his music. Incredible artist.
Super dope.
Ivy League graduate from Cornell.
Mm-hmm.
Just like a great guy, really smart, really educated. And I hadn't met his parents before. I figured they were cool, but like I met him and I was like, bro, like your parents are amazing. Like they love each other. Paul's black.
And all of a sudden it all makes sense. It's like you see this spectacular kid and then you see their parents. It's like, apple doesn't fall far.
And I was like, bro, if I had your parents, I could have went to an Ivy League school.
You know?
You know what I'm saying?
Totally.
And so I think most people know.
Yeah.
But maybe they don't.
I don't. Most people that I talk to have never actually thought critically about their own privilege in that way.
That's crazy.
Or they get so defensive. You know, white people get so defensive about the concept of like just white privilege, and it's just like these things, and just focusing on all that. But it's so much more nuanced than that. And
that's good.
I think that's where
it's
we gotta
good,
go.
Man. This was good. I gotta have you on more often, bro. We got a lot of
subjects we could hit.
That was a lot we hit just now. That's not even an hour. So I'm grateful for you being here, man, and I'm grateful just for you being always willing to sharpen me. And we have a lot of these conversations privately, so I'm grateful that we could have these conversations and show where we agree, where we disagree, and even in how we disagree.
Right, and I think we're
still looking for common ground.
And we can both, like, I think there have been times where you've checked areas where it's like, oh, man, that was a blind spot that I might have had. I wasn't aware of that, you know?
Yeah.
But, man, I appreciate you for doing this, man. Like, it's so needed in our space, and I think it's a great thing.
Thank you, man. You guys, make sure you're following Mogli on all platforms. It's just Mogli the Iceburg everywhere.
MogliTheIceburg.
Leave a comment. What do you guys think? Were you able to watch this and learn something? Were you triggered when we talked about certain things? I want to hear from you guys in the comment section. And let us know what you want us to talk about next, because we are going to have Mogli back again. So appreciate you guys.